Yoli. Today, we're going to take a look at patch 11.17. And the first champion to receive changes this patch is Akshan. Akshan can no longer revive his teammates while he's dead himself. His E, Heroic Swing, now deals less base damage, but scales better towards later stages of the game. If Akshan's ultimate is cancelled, it will now go on a shorter cooldown. And on top of that, he's getting a bunch of bug fixes this patch. Amumu has received some special treatment this patch. His Q, Bandage Toss, now has 2 charges, allowing him to catch up with more friends. And his W, Despair, now deals more damage early, but less damage late. He also got his health and armor growth decreased. The stun duration on his ultimate, Curse of the Sad Mummy, no longer scales and is now the same at all ranks. Echo might be spotted in the jungle more often, again, as his passive now does even more damage to monsters. Our favorite sex demon Evelynn got buffed by having her ultimate cooldown reduced early to mid game. Gangplank will be more vulnerable early game, with his poly now counting as a ranged basic attack and his passive granting less movement speed. But in turn, Pika crit damage on his perils, of which he now has 5 at max rank, will make him even scarier late game. Gravesmith has been really strong, so he's getting his Q mana cost increased, hurting both his wave clear and his lane priority. Master Yi has been very dominant in lower elos, so we better nerf Irelia. Her sustain has been toned down as she now restores less health with her blade surges. Kane, our edgelord, will now be a little bit less edgy because his blue form passive now deals less damage. Leona has been shining a little bit too bright lately, and Riot is clearly preparing for winter by making her W grant less resistances. In further preparation for winter, Lissandra got buffed with higher base attack damage and lower mana cost on her Q. Lucian has only really been viable in mid lane, so Riot is trying to put him back where he belongs, in the bot lane. To start off, his base attack damage has been lowered, and he got an additional passive, Vigilance, which empowers Lucian's next 2 auto attacks to deal bonus magical damage. Each time when an ally buffs him or procs his W, he gets a stack of Vigilance, and a total of 2 stacks of Vigilance can be stored. Furthermore, his ultimate now gets more shots depending on Lucian's crit chance, but it starts off with a lower number of shots, which deal less damage per shot than before. Riot also seems to want to see more Nami, buffing her base health and lowering the mana cost on her W, Ebb and Flow. Senna is getting some nice buffs. She got her critical damage increased a little bit, and she will drop more souls when she is the one last hitting minions and monsters, which will make her more viable as a farming carry. Teemo simply got more unhit damage on his E, but Viego has received more attention than usual. His tanky builds have been too dominant, so Riot is trying to shift more power into aggressive builds by increasing the damage scaling on his possession healing by lowering its base healing. On top of this, his base attack range got reduced and his Q damage multiplier from crit chance was increased. He also gets detected in his harrowed path from slightly further away, and his ult slows for a shorter duration now. Xayah has received some feel-good buffs, lowering the cast time on her Q depending on how much attack speed she has. Plus, her ultimate got a nice flat damage increase. Set now has greater AD scalings on his Q, but lower AD scalings on his E, and his ultimate cooldown has been increased at level 11 and 16. And now to the item changes. Divine Sunder got a little less AD. Serpent's Fang got less lethality. Wit's End now deals less honor damage in the early game. And Humo's Ghostblade got a little less AD, but now grants ability haste. For the runes, only Fleet Footwork was touched. Healing for ranged and melee was increased. But against minions, it now heals significantly less for melee, and a little less for ranged champions. And that's it for the 11.17 patch. I hope you guys enjoyed.